Hey guys, so I'm heading over to the Glebe Markets. This wasn't planned. I don't even have any lipstick on, but I thought I'd show you what they have as part of the secondhand community here in Sydney. I'm so unprepared for this that I just brought my phone. I don't even have my earphones with a microphone on, so I'm just gonna look stupid. But yeah, there's a few entrances on here. And if you're gonna come here, I would suggest that you bring cash with you because not all of them accept cards to tap. So, yeah. Lots of denim, plants, old t-shirts. Secondhand shoes as well. I find that there's a lot of Doc Martens around here. So if you're looking for secondhand Doc Martens, this would be a good place to start. There's like vintage things around here. Speaking of Doc Martens, there we go. Nice boots. $10, $5, $2 stuff.
Take back?
Some people are just bringing their suitcases filled with stuff that they want to sell. I would have sold stuff here, but they ask you to pay $140 for a spot, and I don't even know if I'm going to earn that back, so I just went ahead and donated my stuff to Salvos. I'm seeing some overalls that I like, corduroys and linen, only for $40. I might have to purchase one. Oh, this one's pretty. Unfortunately, it's not my size, it's a size too small. How cute is that?
You still haven't worn them,
I know. Now would be a good time for me to get one of those corduroy skirts that I didn't get at Zara yesterday. Some of them have makeshift dressing rooms around here. There's also some food stalls. Ooh, succulents. Might be a good opportunity to snag some lingerie or silk dresses, like this one here. There's also a whole lot of handmade jewelry. Jackie Lestrange. I always gravitate towards rust-colored anything, really. There's a nice skirt over there, but the sizes are too small. Because a lot of these things are like being sold by people who pre-own them.
This is what I'm talking about,
Maddie. This stall I love. It's all about sustainability, reusable items. That's a really cool guitar made from an Arnold's tin. Healing stones that I don't believe in. Some phone cases. I of patches. Holy shit, film cameras. Soy candles. More vintage. Silver jewelry. Leather goods. Okay, so I tried on this pair of white Levi's. I see you guys now, I've been looking for them for a while. But I find the sizing of old Levi's quite weird. Because this particular one says that it is a size 30 or a 12 for Australia and UK. Or in the US, that's a size 8, I believe. But it doesn't fit, it doesn't even close. And I'm usually a 28. The diesel jeans that I'm wearing right now is a 28. So I mean, I just find it really weird. I was wanting to get that pair of white Levi's, but and I was just gonna cut it because it was quite long, but it doesn't even fit. Like, how? How is it two sizes larger than my normal size, but it still doesn't fit? More clothes, but I don't think this ones are secondhand or vintage. How cute are these mugs?
Just interesting.
All vintage. It's a corduroy boiler suit. That must be really warm. This is cute. This is cute, butterfly, cropped, but it's fucking $55, no thanks. And now people are hungry, so they walk to the side. Okay, so that was Glebe Markets. I didn't end up buying anything because, to be honest, I don't really need anything or want anything. So I left. This is my jacket that I came with, and I left with nothing. There's still a lot of people. It's not gonna finish until 4 p.m. But yeah, so I'm now gonna go home, get some nap, and I'm quite happy that I didn't spend any money on unneeded and unnecessary things. Okay, I'll see you all again in the next video. Thanks for watching. Holy shit, look at that traffic. All because of the market. Yeah, I'm going home.